بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Greet you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series concerning 200 Q&A. And inshallah, this is segment number 19 and question number 49. ما هو توحيد الربوبية؟ Define the توحيد of Lordship or Godship. How to single Allah سبحانه وتعالى concerning His Godship or Lordship. هو الإقرار الجازم بأن الله تعالى رب كل شيء ومليكه وخالقه ومدبره والمتصرف فيه. To confirm, to affirm with no inch of doubt that Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the Lord, the God, the King, the possessor of all things, the creator and the originator, and the one who's in charge of everything. He never have a partner in his ownership. No one can defeat His command. No one have a saying about His decision. No opposite of Him, no equal to Him. No one fighting with Him over His kingdom or His lordship. In any fashion. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Surah Al-An'am, verse number 1, Alhamdulillahi alladhi khalaqa as-samawati wal-ard wa ja'ala adh-dhulumati wan-nur. All praise is due to Allah, the creator of the heaven and the earth, and He is the one who made the light and the darkness. And the statement of Allah in the Fatiha, the opening chapter, Alhamdu lillahi rabbil alameen. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord of all things, all created things. The statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, Allah is the one who created you, then He provide you, then He caused you to die, and then He will revive you. Is there any of your partners or whom you call in do any of these things? Glory be to Him concerning what He associate with Him. Surah Ar-Rum, verse number 40. The statement of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, هَذَا خَلْقُ اللَّهِ فَأَرُونِيَ مَاذَا خَلَقَ الَّذِينَ مِن دُونِي فَأَرُونِي مَاذَا خَلَقَ الَّذِينَ مِن دُونِي. Indeed, these are the creation of Allah. So show me, who other creator beside Him? Or show me what you calling in create as He create. Allah is saying in Surah At-Tur, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ. Has He been created with nothing, or they are the creators? Allah Almighty is saying, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. Nothing equal to Him. Nothing similar to Him. And he's saying, وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا. And say, all praise due to Allah that he didn't begotten a son. Neither he has a partner or an equal in his dominion. So there is a lot of verses to show you that Tawheed al-Rububiyyah is the Tawheed of Godship or Lordship, talking about the creation is only belong to Allah. The command is only belong to Allah. That he is the only provider. That he is the only Lord of everything. And that he is the only one runs the affairs of every created being. Question number 50. ما هو ما ضد توحيد الربوبية? What is the opposite of singling Allah concerning his Godship or Lordship? The opposite of this, for someone to believe that there is one other than Allah or with Allah, have control over things or run the affair of things. That for you to believe or to think that someone other than Allah or with Allah has control over things, run the affairs of the creation, or make things exist or demolish, or give life or cause death, or bring about good or remove the harm and the evil. If you believe that somebody other than Allah or with Allah can harm or benefit or gives life or cause death or run the affairs of the stars, the moon, the weather, anything, that means you are associating partner with Allah concerning his Godship or Lordship, or knowing that there is an equal to Allah in his knowledge, or that there is one other than Allah or with Allah, knowing the unseen. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Fatir, ما يفتح الله للناس من رحمة فلا ممسك لها وما يمسك فلا مرسل له من بعده وهو العزيز الحكيم. يا أيها الناس اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم هل من خالق غير الله يرزقكم من السماء والأرض. Surah Fatir, verse 2 and 3. Whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open a gate of mercy, no one other than Allah can withhold this mercy. And whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala withhold whatever it is, no one else can give it. He is almighty, all wise. O mankind, remember the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. Is there any other creator beside Allah who provides for you from the heaven and the earth? And also Allah is saying in Surah Yunus, وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وَإِن يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَّ لِفَضْلِهِ. If Allah touches you with any harm, no one can remove it other than Allah. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you any good, no one other than Allah can keep it away from you. Also the verses a lot in this issue, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ لَا يَعْلَمُهَا إِلَّا هُوَ. that he possessed the keys of all the unseen. No one other than him knows him. And Allah is saying in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 255, وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءٍ. No one possess anything from the knowledge of Allah except with his permission. That means the angels, the jinn, the messengers, the prophets, the scholars, the awliya, the living, the dead, no one possesses anything from the knowledge of Allah unless Allah will and permit to release some of this knowledge to this selected one by revealing to him. How the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam know about what's in Jannah or what's in hellfire? How did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about the signs of the day of judgment? Because all this from the knowledge of Allah, because Allah had allowed for him to access of some of this knowledge through revelation. Okay? وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءٍ. No one possess any of Allah's knowledge except by his will and his permission. With this, inshallah, we come to conclusion to this segment. Thank you for being here. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك. نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. And Allah knows best.